your vantage point, was that pass intended for Nick?
No. I think it's absolute BS that he doesn't get a steal on the stat sheet because that was he stole that pass. I told him, if you're going to steal a pass, you better make the shot. And it was a pretty incredible shot by him. So obviously was, you know, why we, one of the reasons we like Nick out on the court at the end of the game. He's not afraid of the moment. He loves the moment. He made a big shot for us.
As Russ was starting to cook there towards the end, what were you seeing defensively? It seemed like you were switching different guys on.
Yeah, well, he got hot. He hit some really tough shots. I thought we did a pretty good job on Russ for most of the night, just making it hard on him. And you're never going to, I've said it before, a superstar is, you're never going to shut down. It's all about how hard you make them work. And I thought we did a good job of that for the most part. And then, you know, obviously when he got cooking, they did a nice, you know, substitutions and put shooters out there so we couldn't really blitz it, you know, which was one of the plans. So we tried switching 1 through 5, went a little smaller, and he just kept making shots. And, you know, we got hands up. We lost him one time off an offensive rebound. That happens. But, you know, he was, you know, that's what he does.
Most coaches say that big wins or those losses can take a lot out of the team. Do you worry anything?
It's
the big win, obviously, tomorrow.
No, I mean, I'm happy for the guys. You know, it's obviously a win. You know, you love wins; they're fun. But I thought our focus level was better tonight than it's been in a long time. You know, so as far as building and getting better as a team, I was really impressed with how locked in we were we were for most of the night. With the playing the Warriors, you got plenty to worry about other than an emotional hangover. So I told the guys, it's us and the Spurs are the only two teams that have beat them, and we beat them last. So they're probably the ones that are a little nervous right now as we get ready to fly up to Oakland. that's funny. But no, it's, I mean, obviously the guys are excited, we're all excited, but it's part of the job. You get on a plane, get a good night's sleep, and mentally prepare for the next one.
You had mentioned yesterday you wanted that first unit to pick up the pace and the tempo. Did you like what you saw from that?
Yeah, I thought Jose did a great job filling in. I mean, hit big shots, but not only that, the way he was getting, you know, getting the guys involved and moving the ball and defensively competing his tail off. You know, he was great. I was a little worried. I walked by him after the game and he already had an ice bag on. So we'll see how he feels tomorrow, but he was great for us tonight.
You are obviously a pretty young team. As young teams go, you know, they generally have to learn that when this game could have gotten away from you guys, is this one of those games that like can be instructive and help in the maturation process?
Absolutely. And I feel like even if we would have lost tonight, we wouldn't have let this one get away. They made some incredible shots down the stretch. I thought our guys were playing well. We got a little stagnant at the end, but that's also on us coaches. We got to make sure that it was a different lineup than we normally play, that no matter what's going on, we can get to, you know, at least a couple sets that are for sure going to get us a good look. So, you know, if they would have wanted this, because, you know, they made incredible plays, not because we gave it away.
Yeah,
so
I gave it away is probably the wrong term. Let's reverse it. The fight to stay in that game, considering like one loss.
That goes back to what I was saying, the focus we had. You know, it's especially for a young team, it's easy to quit when they're coming downhill and everything they're shooting is going in, and we got to match bucket for bucket. We can't just rely on what we've already scored. Brandon hit some big threes in the fourth. Guys kept trusting each other. Different guys were making plays. So I definitely think it's another one of those stepping stones in gaining confidence and knowing that type of situation. You know, you can learning how to hold off that runaway train that's coming at you.
Have you heard about getting mention of his hip at all tonight, or is he fine with that?
No, he seemed to be favoring it a little bit early on. And I felt like he kind of, I don't know if it was hurting or you know, if it was just in his head, but he seemed to me a little less aggressive tonight than he's been. But I don't know. I haven't asked him yet how the hip felt. You know, every time I asked him during the game, he said it feels good. But that's what most athletes tell you. So I don't know if it was hurting or not.